older antimalarial drug potent against COVID-19 in labs. A team of researchers at the University of New Mexico Health Sciences investigated drug purposing for COVID-19. This approach has been explored already by other research groups, but there are numerous existing drugs out that have not been tested yet. For their study, an older antimalarial drug is determined potent against SARS-CoV-2, at least in the lab. Dr. Chudor Opria, chief of the UNM Division of Translational Informatics, said, "The gist of it is we think we found a drug that is on par with remdesivir and is much cheaper." Remdesivir is currently the most commonly used investigational drug against COVID-19. Aside from its invasive administration, the supply of this medication can be problematic in various areas. Thus, drug purposing is essential to increase the list of usable drugs for COVID-19. In this study, researchers searched through a library of previously approved drugs. These drugs are believed to speed up the recovery of those infected with SARS-CoV-2. A total of 4,000 approved drugs were analyzed by the team. Out of all the drugs studied for molecular characteristics, three were found promising. One of these three is the antimalarial drug called amodiaquine. The other two promising drugs are sucralfentexol, an antipsychotic drug, and nebivolol, an antihypertensive medication. All three drug candidates have been tested in lab settings. Researchers examined the performance of the drugs in targeting vulnerabilities of the coronavirus. Results suggested that in test tubes, all candidates cleared the virus. But amodiaquine was the most effective among the three. The team thinks that combining one of the three candidates with remdesivir or similar antiviral drugs like favipiravir may work. The combination therapy may result in a greater potency in clearing the coronavirus. The approach offers a major upside and downside. Using both drugs will increase the chances of side effects. This can be mitigated by lowering the doses of each medication. On the other hand, the administration of two drugs can decrease the risk of the virus to mutate. By decreasing that risk, the virus will be less likely to become immune to the treatment. Despite promising lab results, tested drugs may not perform similarly in living organisms. So, researchers are planning to take the candidates to the next step, a human clinical trial. Amodiaquine was first made in 1948 and is currently included in the WHO's list of essential medicines. The study results were published in ACS Pharmacology and Translational Science.